Hello there. Today's video is on how to become a software testing expert in your team or company. There are some strong reasons to become a software testing expert, so let us get started. First of all, let us discuss who is a software testing expert. Different people understand different things when somebody says an expert. But by an expert, I mean a very highly skilled professional who is able to produce great results. The next question is, why become an expert? There can be reasons of prestige or greater professional satisfaction. But in my opinion, the biggest reason of becoming an expert is that it ends up giving you more money because it provides you more and better work opportunities, and it provides you opportunities to make more money. The next question is, how to become an expert? There are two steps to become an expert. First, you should become very highly skilled in software testing. And the second step is, you should build your reputation in software testing. Depending on your ambition, you may want to become an expert in your team, department, unit, company, industry, or even your country or the whole world. Depending on the things you do, you may become an expert in any of these realms. So let us see the first step in becoming an expert, and that is how to become very highly skilled in software testing. There are some things you should do in order to become highly skilled in software testing. So first of all, make a long-term commitment to software testing. Becoming an expert is not an overnight process, so you have to make a long-term commitment to getting very highly skilled in software testing. Then learn on a daily basis. There is a wealth of new articles, new blogs, discussions on software testing, videos on software testing that are published every day. So make it a point that you learn something new about software testing every day. Simply learning new things in software testing is not sufficient. You should also practice testing every day. Then, whatever you have learned and whatever you have practiced, try to integrate that in your existing knowledge. When you work on projects, aim to provide big value or results to your clients. And always focus on the results. Understand why clients want their systems tested and what will give them the biggest return on their investment in you. When you're working in projects, some of the things that can help you produce better results are the following. Review the system requirements often. So that will give you a better grasp of the system requirements, and also review the changes to the system requirements. So whenever there are any changes to the system requirements and you test it immediately, you may find more or better bugs. Design and test with interesting test data. You can use several test design techniques like equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis, state transition diagrams, pairwise testing, and so on, and that will give you better results in your testing. Don't be satisfied with testing positively, but also test negatively to see if negative inputs are given, the system is able to handle those negative inputs correctly. Then, instead of just focusing within the system, make it a point to test the external interfaces, interfaces to other systems. So these other systems can also change, and the system you are testing should be able to communicate to and fro with these external systems correctly. One of the areas that is not tested very much is the system configuration settings. So you can make it a point to test out the system configuration settings, and that will lead you to find more or better bugs. You can also generate ideas from the prior bugs that have been found in the system and use those test ideas for better testing. As you are testing, you can create a to-do list for later testing, because when you are testing, you may get some ideas. So have a running to-do list, and when you finish your tests, you can go back to your to-do list and do those tests also. Don't be satisfied with just testing the area that is assigned to you, but also test outside your area. That way you'll have a bigger scope in which to find out more severe bugs or bugs that are across the different areas of the system. One technique that you can use is to test at different speeds. Instead of just going through the tests very rapidly, slow down. When you slow down, you will start to observe other things that you had not observed before, and that way you can do a more thorough testing. Always keep track of the bug reports that you log so that you can learn more from them. So apart from these points, you can make your own methodology to provide big value in testing. That is when you are testing in your project. So what do you do if you are not on any project? Still, you learn every day and you test every day. You can have a favorite or a pet project that you can test every day, or you can contribute to any of the large number of open source projects out there and contribute to them with your testing. But make sure that you learn on a daily basis and practice testing on a daily basis. The next step in becoming a software testing expert is to build your reputation in software testing. It is not sufficient that you are highly skilled in software testing. Other people should know about it, especially the people who can provide you better opportunities and better money. So you also need to build your reputation in software testing. So what are some of the ways by which you can do so? First of all, update your professional profile. If you are going to aim to become a software testing expert within your company, you should update your professional resume that is within the company, update it with all the different skills you have, your different achievements or accomplishments, the results that you have provided. If you're looking to become a software testing expert in a bigger realm like your industry or even globally, then you should update your public professional profile and add the different skills and your achievements over there. Next is communicate often. So it is not enough that you know a lot about software testing, you know many different insights about software testing. You should also share these insights with other people so that they also know that there is a lot to be learned from you in software testing. The next thing to do is to nurture your supporters. As you start to become a software testing expert, you will find that there are some people who genuinely like you and who promote your work, who promote the good things that you do. So identify these people so that they can provide testimonials for your very high level of skill in software testing, provide you recommendations, or generally spread the word about your accomplishments to others. Then don't shy away from difficult projects. So always volunteer for the more critical or more expensive or longer projects, the more difficult projects. So this will enable you to put all your skills into the project, and then you will learn a lot from these projects, and your contribution to such projects will be admired more by the people. Share your knowledge. So if you have developed your own tools or your own software testing techniques or some documents, don't keep it to yourself. So if you want to become a software testing expert in your team, just share your tools, share your documents with other members of the team. If you want to become a software testing expert in your company, share the tools that you have created, share the techniques that you have created across the company, and so on. be interested in other projects. So if you want to become a software testing expert in your company, don't just be interested in just your own project, but be also interested in other projects. There may be opportunities for helping others with your insights and your guidance. Always look forward to the future. Find out what is happening in the software testing industry, which way the industry is going. For instance, some years ago, projects used to be executed in the waterfall software development lifecycle. But these days, agile software development lifecycle is very popular. So that way you can look forward to the future, know what are the new tools coming in software testing, what are the new processes in software testing, so that you can prepare for the future also. Be open to criticism, but always respond logically. When you are becoming a software testing expert, some people may like to challenge the things that you say, or some people may want to question you. So always be open to criticism. So that is a very common part of becoming a software testing expert. But always respond logically, build your case and provide data why you recommend certain things or why you don't recommend certain things, and respond logically. As frequently as possible, write and speak. So depending on the realm in which you want to become the software testing expert, if you want to become a software testing expert within your company, you can write in the company newsletter. If you want to become a software testing expert in a bigger realm, you can blog. If you have to speak, so in the company, you can speak in the trainings, you can speak in the meetings. And if you want to become a software testing expert on a global basis, then you can speak at the different conferences. Initially, you may not get opportunities to speak at the bigger conferences, but you can start small and aim to get opportunities to speak. So whenever you get the opportunity to write and speak, so use those opportunities. So generally, you build your reputation in testing if you are in the news for the good reasons. If you do become a software testing expert, people will say that I know one thing about him or I know one thing about her. It is rare to find such high software testing skills. So if you want solid results quickly, so better have him or her in the project. So this is on becoming a software testing expert in your team or company. Remember, it is not a simple thing to do. There are many things you have to do over the long term. But when you become an expert, then you will find that you are getting more and better opportunities to make more money and to contribute more. And there are two steps to becoming a software testing expert. First, become very highly skilled in software testing, and then build your good reputation in software testing. So all the best from my side, and thank you very much.